然后他说，在今年的7月1号开始，这是加州的法律规定，每一个家庭一定要安装一氧化碳侦测器，除了这个烟雾侦测器，还要加一氧化碳侦测器。那爸爸说，一层就要有一个，不一定是每一个房间，但是一层一定要有一个。如果你是一层楼，只要装一个；如果是两层楼，一层一定要装一个。那刚刚这位先生说，那可是我住 apartment 呢，也是要装。为什么？因为这个一氧化碳呢，我们知道说有的时候，比如说瓦斯的燃烧不完全，或者是有的比较旧式的那个暖气系统是用那个 gasoline 去那个汽油去燃烧，当它燃烧不完全的时候，它就产生一氧化碳。一氧化碳是无嗅无味的，那你就陷入昏迷，这样子。所以这个是加州的漏，7月1号开始，每一个家都一定要装一氧化碳侦测器。
那个麻烦问一下，你的规格放在哪？因为你只有一层楼，楼上楼下像这个花园，它也是规定30。
So, her question is that then where do we install that? That the house is just one story. Where would you recommend to install?
It is recommended that it should be maybe in a hall near the bedrooms, because then if there is carbon monoxide, it is eventually going to reach that area and wake everybody up and get you out in time. Carbon monoxide will kill you. There's no two ways about it. You have to have a carbon monoxide detector so that you can open the windows. That will help immediately and get out of the house and get it cleared out.
所以 Barbara 的建议是说，把这个一氧化碳侦测器要安装在这个后卫，就是走廊靠近卧室的地方，因为我们睡觉我们是关房门的，对不对？所以呢，我们睡着了我们就不知道。可是当这个一氧化碳靠近房门的时候，哎，它侦测到它就会作响，那我们就会醒过来。所以基本上，比如说客厅不太需要，因为客厅是开放式的空间，好，所以呢，他说这个一氧化碳的侦测器是要靠近房间的那个走廊上，这样。
Do you have to gas? If you don't have gas at home, you still need them?
How do you heat your?
所以这整个 building 是符合是符合9级、10级以上的地震的规模的。No, the gym will open as a shelter for emergency because it is built to meet the requirement of the law. Yeah.
Okay, so we've been talking about earthquakes, and just to give you a little definition, it's a sudden slipping or movement of a portion of the Earth's crust caused by a sudden release of stresses, usually from less than 25 miles below the surface. Okay, we know the Fukushima earthquake was about 20 miles deep, and you can see all the damage that it caused.So we have, right in our area, we have the North American plate and we have the Pacific plate. And they are slowly moving against each other all the time. If you, I'll let you say that first and then I'll tell them where they can look. Okay.
所以我们都知道说在三月的时候日本刚有这个大地震发生，那地震我们都知道说就是因为地球的板块他们在移动的时候所释放的能量。好，那通常就是这个欧美板块跟亚太板块它们互相慢慢的摩擦，然后就释放出这个能量出来。
Okay. So here's a picture of the two plates, the North American plate and the Pacific plate. Pacific plate is moving north. So maybe in several million years, Los Angeles will be up here, you know, but we don't know. We won't be here. But it is definitely moving. And if you go out to Civic Center near the BART station, you will find... Where did I lose it?
Did I lose it?
Oh, there it is. If you go out to Civic Center and near the BART station, you will see areas where the curb in the street has moved away from it or up or backwards or down. if there's evidence that the Hayward Fault is creeping, it's moving so slowly, we think maybe that will help us in an earthquake because there's not as much stress there at our point as perhaps up in San Pablo, where that creeping is not happening. So stress is building up more there than it is here.
No. Let us say place. What does it say, place? Is it Fremont? nothing is safe.
Nothing is safe. You just saw that there was a big earthquake on the East Coast. That very rarely happens because most of the East Coast is one plate of the earth. Not like here where we have two plates moving against each other, and yet there was an earthquake.
那我们刚刚说这个图片呢，告诉我们就是两个板块在互相运动。那我们知道说太平洋板块它是往北移动的。他说也许有一天报几百万年以后呢，我们会发现洛杉矶已经跑到北边来的也不一定哈。这是我们不知道的。那Barbara 说，我们可以看到，如果您有时间的话，靠近我们 Fremont Fire Station 有一个街叫做 Civic Center 那里。 那你如果仔细看，在路旁啊，这个人行道还有路，他们有一些比较高起的或者比较低陷的，或者有那个就是在我们这个黑卧板块移动的现象，那这是一个好现象，就是说它是慢慢在移动。如果它有在慢慢移动的话，表示说它的能量是在慢慢被释放，所以比较不用担心说突然间一个大的震动，然后就有大的地震发生，这是一个情形。 那刚刚这位先生问说，那到底哪里是安全的呢？我们不知道哪里是一个安全的地方，甚至说，我们也知道说，在上个月，在那个纽约有一个大地震，哈，那其实是这几乎是百年来纽约的第一个大地震。那因为纽约本身它是一个大的板块，不是像这里有很多的断层，很多的板块在移动。 所以呢，大家也都很surprise， 所以没有办法说哪里还是一个安全、没有地震的。